How's it going, everyone? This is Kevin. Today, I want to bring you along with me to talk about why I believe that your phone won't be replacing your pro camera just yet. So let's jump right into it. If you've been keeping up with the latest news of Apple, they came out with their iPhone 13 and all that line. I only have the 12 Pro Max, which I'm going to be kind of comparing my thoughts behind why I believe phone cameras have come a long way, but they're not really there yet to replace any of these cameras if you're wanting to take your photography and videography seriously. One of the main things that I saw with the iPhone 13 is their cinematic mode, which can kind of help you rack focus between whatever you want in the scene, whether it's a person or an object, which in theory sounds phenomenal. But at the end of the day, it's only shot at 1080p, which to me is not something that is very, I guess, useful when it comes onto a phone. The idea behind it is really cool, but in reality, I don't believe that it's something that's gonna be replacing a good pro camera that you could be investing in if you really wanna hone your craft, whether it's video or photo. Now, don't get me wrong, if you're a type of person that has to have only one thing to kind of be able to create and also be able to take phone calls and whatever you need to do, having a good phone is very beneficial. Whether you have the 12 Pro Max, the 12 Pro, the new 13, or anything like that, the best camera that you can have is the one that you have with you at all times. But if you want to get a little bit more serious into your photography and videography, these type of phones are great to a certain limit. There's a lot of disadvantages having just a simple phone, even with the three lenses that they have, because in reality, they're not that great of quality besides their main native lens, which is the wide one, because the ultra wide versus the telephoto is very different when it comes down to the quality, which isn't horrible, but depending on the situation with how well the light is, it can be pretty bad. Now, the cool thing about having a pro camera, in my opinion, is obviously having the interchangeable lenses so you can get a better just quality overall with the type of lens that you want to use for the type of scenery or whatever you need to have for having better compression with telephoto lenses. The iPhone 11 or 12 Pro Max and I think the 11 Pro Max as well, I think the telephoto lens is a 65 millimeter equivalent, which isn't horrible, but it's also not anything phenomenal like an 85 prime lens that you can get, or if you have a zoom telephoto lens like that. One of the more beneficial things if you have a pro camera, it's just having a better sensor size, because the sensor of these is, well, this is a full frame camera, but even having a APS-C sensor camera is just gonna give you a lot better quality than just what your phone can do. There's a lot of algorithm and just kind of AI that goes into these phones to make your footage nicer, but at the same time, that's what I think takes away from a nice, basically, setup of footage, is that it looks just too good and unrealistic because of all the things they want to add to it to make it look perfect. Some of the things that people really like to shoot, for example, film, is to show a little bit of the imperfections when it comes down to the photo or video, even when it comes down to a lot of movies. Like, I think Chris Nolan only shoots in film with his production, which gives it that sort of look, which is pretty cool in my opinion. Something that I noticed that a lot of people want to recreate a lot is just film. So having a phone isn't horrible because there are apps that can help you out to simulate that and whatnot, but it's also very limiting with what you can do with the phone. You're able to add attachments if you want to, like the Moment, they have a case where you can add any basically lenses and extensions to it, but it only gets you so far as well. The sensors of these are rather quite small, if you can kind of tell right there. So for me, it's just, it doesn't really make sense, I guess, to be going with just a camera or overtaking a pro camera just yet. They have come a long ways going back to a lot of the older phones and everything like that, but they're not quite there yet. Now, something that I think would be kind of cool to have eventually on a phone would be to have an actual sensor kind of maybe put into it, where it's a more driven camera phone, where people that want to take their photography a little bit more serious, they might be able to have a better sensor size so that you can get better quality. A lot of the times with these phones, the sensor size is what really takes away from the quality. Sometimes depending on the lighting, you can get really cool stuff, but overall it is very limiting when it comes down to a more professional camera, even if it's the lower end kind of mirrorless cameras that you get nowadays. Despite having a decent amount of megapixels in this camera, it can't compare to a lot of what a APS-C or even full frame camera can give you when it comes down to the quality. So in my opinion, I think that phone photography has come a long way, but it hasn't really reached a level that it will replace any pro cameras. I'm not sure if you ever saw this a while back where they were talking about how phone photography was gonna be so much bigger than all these cameras and they're gonna be running them out of business and everything in between. But if you've noticed, all these camera companies are actually thriving even more now. I feel more people know that they're gonna get the quality that they want and deserve through having a better camera system than relying on a phone. I think iPhones and Samsungs and everything like that, they do have phenomenal cameras when it comes down to their system, but I don't think it's gonna be appealing too much to an actual professional photographer or want somebody that wants to have some sort of professionalism in their photography to simply just use a phone. Maybe eventually, who knows, but that's just my two cents when it comes down to it. I know the iPhone 13 is out and they're raving about how good the quality is of the cinematic mode, but to me, it's still not that great because a lot of the times you'll see that the halo around people's basically portrait kind of style of focal length, basically like depth that they're trying to provide isn't as nice because it's just the same way that when you shoot portrait mode on your phone, you can tell when it's digital and when it's an actual like lens itself. So it does have a long way, but eventually with everything that's happened, I think they're gonna be closer and closer to it. With that said, I mean, I'll leave the question up to you. Do you think your phone can overtake your camera currently, or would you invest into a better camera system with lenses, or would you want to get an iPhone 13 Pro Max and invest into it? Because I know they can come out to about $1,000 to $1,500 now, especially with depending what your memory size that you wanna have. So is that worth the investment to you to go with a new iPhone, or try to get a more pro level camera and wait a little bit longer just to get like everything that you want with it for the long-term haul? Let me know down below and I would love to know your thoughts and you know, any opinions that you might have with what we covered today. But with all that said and done, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure to like and subscribe, share this video with a friend. I'll catch you guys in the next one. See ya.